the million question. I must tell you this, that over the years, something that stands out about me and the people that come to me is what I see in Kebadua. God always brings people who have one problem or the other, my way. And by the time they come, they live as a mighty man. They live as mighty men. Now, I mean, I have had instances where God brings to me drug addicts. Yeah, people who are condemned, and then people who have left school, and then to autism or drugs and everything, and then they were restored. Today they're pastors.
Wow.
Today they're pastors.
Wow.
They have their ministries. They are attached, affiliated with that, affiliated with that. You know, but they're their own. So it's been a wonderful experience seeing God, you know, not just working in person, but transforming them.
Transforming them
into his own image and likeness. It's an amazing thing to see. You know, imagine somebody who spends his days and his nights in the nightclub, drinking what they call paraga. No, it's not paraga. Paraga all day long. That's what he does day every day, 24/7. Then suddenly, he's telling you now that he cannot even take paraga, he cannot even do anything, he cannot even read novel.
Yeah.
What he does is his Bible.
Wow, such a transition.
Without any contact, just come and then God minister to him, and that's all. And today he has his own ministry as a pastor. But sometimes this person, one amongst them, if he's talking, you think it's me.
Wow.
Is that.
Wow.
I mean, so I hear him talk and I wonder, it's me talking.
Amazing.
But yeah, it's really awesome.
Wow.
And I give God all the glory for that.
Thank you so much for being such an outstanding soul.
Thank you so
much. There is this situation here. You realize more often you have people who, rather than share their problems, or talk to someone, or talk to a counselor like you, they will want to buckle up due to the experiences of the past. So they have this issue with trust. So as an experienced counselor that you are, as a teacher, as a motivator, as a mentor, you know, what do you have to say about this?
Thank you. You know, one of the greatest things I've always told everyone is this: you cannot teach somebody what you have not experienced.
Wow.
It is impossible to teach anyone what I have not experienced. Because if I tell you now that I can handle a drug addict because I was there. I mean, my name was Boro. I don't have to say that. Boro. Boro from Marlboro. I mean, I was a drunkard. I was a chain smoker. Now, so when you get people like that, you need to come to that level. Paul said, I do more things to all men so that I can win them to Christ. So, you don't have to carry yourself so high as a pastor. You need to come down to that level. And then, thereby, when you let Christ to them, minister Christ to them, at their level. Otherwise, you will lose them. I mean, you look for anyone saying, don't take drugs. No, don't. You don't do that. You start from your own experience, setting them. I was once like you. You know, things like this, you know. Then gradually, God will do his work. Most of us are very good in condemning people. You're lying off. This can never be. I've learned something about God. What can never be? That's what you know me. When we say God is not, that's where God is. God is never in the place that men look at. It's found what men cannot even see or imagine. So we need to be careful. Now some people, I don't know, I'm yet to find that the link of God and drugs. I don't know. I mean, that's my experience. He seems to have more interest in those drug addicts. I'm here to get it, because most of them turn out to be good pastors. Anyway, history has told us, we found out that they're wonderful pastors today. Right? So the key is coming down to the level and becoming all things to them. Meaning of Christ.
So we could say it's like the deep calling out.
Yeah, to the deep of it.
Interesting. Sir, you're such an articulate writer, author of so many books. I was wondering, which of these books has been quite demanding in terms of your channel, trying to, you know, put it together?
I think that's the book on circumcision.
Circumcision, okay.
That's what I call a teacher's guide. You know, circumcision is poorly understood by many.
Okay.
Many thought to circumcise is to remove the foreskin of the male organ. It's gone beyond that. It has to do with your heart. Most of us, when we come to Christ, our heart is still veiled. So it has to be unveiled. That's to circumcise, to unveil. So 2 Corinthians 3:18, your face must be unveiled. Then you now see the glory transition.
Yes.
Without the unveiling, there can't be transition. So that's why an old man in 20 years in the Lord is still the same old way. He has not been unveiled. So he still has the old attitude as if it's fresh today. Because you know what, the man is born again in the heart of people, but in the heart is not born again. He enjoys the old man because he has there's no change in his heart. It's a beautiful concept. If you get to read that book, you know, because it is not in the flesh, it's in the heart. When God begins to be strong in your heart, remove that veil that covers you, so that the spirit can minister to your spirit and you receive knowledge. True knowledge is when God's spirit minister to your own spirit.
Wow.
So to do that, he has to unveil you first. It's in that book.
Circumcision. Yeah. So we are going beyond the literal meaning of the book for something much deeper.
Oh, deeper.
Wow, you heard it. Circumcision. Look out for that book. So I'm still very curious about that book that you've written that still makes you go wow when you read it. What's that book?
That's the one on grace.
Grace. Okay.
Dynamics of grace.
Dynamics of grace.
Yeah. Now how this works. You know, I ability of God working in me is more important than what I cannot do.
Yes.
In other words, when I see God's ability, I begin to act like God. Mm. That's grace. So, you know, grace again, to the apostolic prayer, grace is given to the apostle, not for the apostle, but for the people. Oh. So God gives grace to apostle to give to other people.
Awesome.
You see? So the apostle is not to be aggrandized or to show himself as an apostle. But it's a kind of God's grace for people that are under you.
Mm-hmm.
So the anointing of grace can rub on them. Mm-hmm. Paul said to tell in chapter 2, he said, God will give me grace for you.
Mm-hmm.
So the grace of God is not for us to have wealth. It's not for us to have all the things of this world.
Mm-hmm.
But for us to give to them who are under us.
Wow.
So we change them to become like us.
Mm-hmm.
That's Christianity.
Mm-hmm.
It changes from the inside. Comes outside.
Mm, mm.
That's start from the heart. Mm. That comes outside. The power of grace.
Mm.
Power of confirmation. You know, after you are transformed, you conform. You understand that God has a mind for you.
Mm.
So it's a beautiful concept at that.
Awesome.
We need to get to that point whereby every leader must learn it's not about program, but it's about building people.
Wow. Yes.
Yes. Mm. Our programs today is just run for our own selfish interests.
Showmanship.
Now, but programs are supposed to build up the body, every individual.
Mm.
So when you don't build men, then the church will tend to build will be destroyed.
Wow. Very revealing, sir.
So you know what you if like, in God you must learn to build men.
Mm.
The men that will hold up the church.
Mm. Mm.
So build them up until they come to the Christ fullness stature in section 43. That's our target. Okay? That everyone must mature.
Mm.
Okay? Don't produce immature Christians that cannot face anything.
Mm.
That's what we have in the country today. So we must learn to make sure that our people are not just workers. They are not just followers, but they're disciples. Disciples are not followers. Disciples are the ones that will stay when they're in trouble.
Mm.
Followers will take the next flight when they're in trouble.
Doctor, I guess this is very, very...
Because they have the money. But disciples have something bigger than the money.
Yeah.
Their belief system is at stake.
Mm.
So they want to fight for what they believe.
Mm.
So raise disciples, don't raise followers.
Wow. Awesome.
Don't raise church doers.
Awesome.
Yes,
awesome.
Disciples of nation, disciples of men. That's what God called us to do.
Mm. I must say that time with you is really valuable. At this point, sir, what would you advise those who are aspiring for greater heights, particularly very challenging, particularly when they find themselves in very challenging situations?
I asked that question because in one of my writings recently I spoke about the lessons from the school of faith.
Mm-hmm.
You know, patience is one of the virtues that God wants to give to us as leaders.
Mm-hmm.
One of the fruit of the spirit is patience. Now, when God said a thing to you, you don't need to ask him where will it be. Is a hard one to believe. Because most of the time, God doesn't work with what we think it is. If I say today, and today can mean another 20 years. Now, so everyone who's coming to ministry, one, must not come because of money. Okay. Must come because they fall in love with God. Mm. In other words, fall in love with God of the assignments. Mm. Get to know his person. Because knowing his person will make you to know his kind of the assignment you're supposed to do. He will tell you how to do it. Now when you have the revelation, nothing weighs you out. Even if it's taken 18 years in ministry, I said earlier. I mean, if you haven't taken, you wouldn't know. Because I'm enjoying myself. Why? Because I've gotten to fall in love with this person. So the assignment in my hand becomes very easy. That's the truth.
Wow.
That's the truth. Wow. So the young people are coming up, we need to have this same understanding, all right? That first of all, fall in love with the God of the work, not the work.
Oh,
yes. Mm. When you fall in love with God of the work, you will love his work.
Awesome.
You will love his work. Wow. Not for lucre, not for future lucre, not for what you are going to gain, but because of who he is, his person. Mm. You love with him because of who he is, and then. And years will pass by. Many will throw things at you. Many will call you idiots. Many will call you names and things like that. It's not for you to defend yourself. It is for you to stay focused on who he has called you. Mm-hmm. Knowing that it's faithful.
It's faithful.
Yes.
And the right time. Awesome. Awesome. Thank you so much. It's been such a revealing moment with you. And I must say, for those of you who love to get his works, you will definitely give you the contacts and give you the feedback on how to get in touch with Dr. Olugbami. I'm sure you would agree with me that this is a time worth spending. And just stay tuned for many more episodes such as this. Until coming your way again next time. From Doctor.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
Nice having me.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.